Uganda, I write in Rutu and English using the Latin alphabet.
I had a difficult childhood, a lot going on. School was a safe place for me. A lot of the adults in the school building, whether it was coaches or teachers, really helped me see my potential. Actually, it was my chemistry teacher, my basketball coach, and my football coach, all three, same guy. He asked me, what are you doing after high school? And I told him, I don't know. And he said, what do you mean you don't know? You're too smart not to go to college. So he talked to me about going to college, and he actually held me accountable to sign up for the SAT and the ACT, and he said, I want to see your scores when you're done. I chose teaching because I wanted to be able to do that for kids one day, be that person. And then another piece too is just, I really like learning about the world. I like learning new things, and so it's what I get to do every day at school with kids. And so it just made it a really fun idea for me to be there for kids and also to continually learn about the world and share that excitement with kids and get them interested in learning new things. My first like 3 years, I was at school every day till 6 p.m., you know, just trying to figure the whole thing out. It was difficult and it was challenging, but it never felt like something that I had to do. It felt like something that I wanted to do. So I think that feeling of just getting up every day and despite the any challenges, having that feeling that like I want to go to work and this is what I want to do and just being interested and engaged in the work every day, that's how I knew it was something that I had found something that clicked for with what I wanted to do. So I don't really think of myself as anything special. So I think that it was humbling to get that recognition and just to be able to represent my colleagues and the profession as a whole, something you know that I care deeply about, and just to be able to use that platform to continually advocate for my colleagues and the kids at school. I want my students to take away from their time here that they can learn anything that they want to know about the world, that they have that power to go out and seek answers and understand. They don't need somebody to tell them what to do or what to think. And I want them to know that whatever they're after for themselves, I want them to continue to think outside of themselves and how they can make the world a better place. The thing that makes teaching the most rewarding is just being able to shut your door and close out all the noise. There's so much of it in education, and just being in here with the kids every day, it really grounds you and reminds you of what's important. And just seeing their excitement, they're just so authentic, especially at this age in second grade. It just reminds you every day about what's important. I incorporate music in the classroom, so every morning we sing a song as part of our morning meeting, and that's part of building the community aspect too. Music's just such a big community builder. Every about 2 weeks we do a new song, and that's the song we sing in the morning, and then at the end of the day we do a launch, so we kind of reflect on our day with our social contract and the goal that we set, check in with ourselves, how did we do today, and then we end the day with a song from a catalog. So the songs that we've learned throughout the year, we go back through them, and whoever is the clicker for that day gets to choose that song. So I try to give my students a lot of options and choice about what they get to do and how they get to do things and when and where, just to show them that really this classroom is not about me, it's about them. I'm just here to just kind of guide them along and point them in that direction. So I tell them, like, we call it this room 132, it's not Mr. B's classroom. And that's kind of like the proper noun for us.
Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.